Section 1.1 is on finding and describing patterns. And if we look closely, we can see we've got a pattern with these zebras. They have a striped pattern that helps protect them from predators. So that's our little pun of the day. We've got patterns in nature. This is the first lesson of the course, and as such, we have an introduction. Geometry and math in general can be described as a process of using logic and finding patterns. And today we're going to focus on the second part of that. We're going to find and describe patterns. So as we look at this first example, they give us four figures, and we need to describe the pattern that's happening in those figures. We're going to learn about this later in the year, but this first shape, a triangle, and then we've got a square. This five-sided one is called a pentagon. And then six sides, that is a hexagon. And again, we're going to learn more about that later in chapter 8. But we need to describe the pattern in the figures. What's happening as I go from one figure to the next? Well, the triangle has three sides. The square has four sides. We already described when we named the pentagon, it has five sides. And the hexagon, six sides. So you can see describing it using numbers really helps the pattern to kind of jump out as we go from three to four to five to six. We're adding a side each time. And that's a good example of what describing a pattern looks like. When we see the words each time, that's kind of telling us how we progress from one figure to the next. Now, they don't have to have a picture or a diagram to give us a pattern that we need to describe. Sometimes they just give us a list of numbers, and that's definitely the case here as well. You can see we go 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18 here in letter A. Sometimes if it's not necessarily obvious right away, it helps to just kind of say, okay, to get from 3 to 6, well, then we added 3. Maybe we'll test that one and then keep going to get from 6 to 9. Hey, I added 3 again. To get from 9 to 12, there's another plus 3. And you know, it works again to get from 12 to 15, to get from 15 to 18. That is our pattern. We are adding 3 each time. And you can see there again is our each time language when we are describing the pattern there. Now, for letter B, it's a little bit more interesting. To get from 1 to 4, I add 3 again. So we're thinking maybe this is the same pattern as letter A up above. Then to get from 4 to 9, we add 5. From 9 to 16, then we add 7. 16 to 25, then we add 9. 25 to 36, then we're adding 11. And there's kind of a pattern within a pattern that's showing up here. Because what we're adding is growing by the same amount each time. And there's a number of different correct ways you can answer this second one. One that I kind of like is you say plus 3, then plus 5, then plus 7, then plus 9, and then dot, dot, dot. That shows that you're continuing that adding pattern each time, and you're showing that dot, dot, dot means that pattern continues. So that is one way of describing that pattern. Another one, and I'd be really impressed if you see this one right away, but these are all perfect square numbers. So for instance, the 1 is really 1 to the second power. 4 is 2 to the second power. Oops. 9 is 3 to the second power, and that pattern continues. So another way of describing the pattern is by saying that 1 squared, comma, then 2 squared, then 3 squared, then 4 squared, and dot, dot, dot. When you get to higher level math classes, this is called a sequence or a series of numbers. We're not going to really look at that too much in depth now. We're just describing the pattern. All right, I'm going to give you a few minutes. If I were you, I would pause the video right now and try and describe the pattern on your own. And we'll come back in about 10 seconds here and go over the answers. So go ahead and pause the video now and try these. All right, well, let's look at number one. To describe the pattern, adding one section each time. Okay, taking one circle and adding one section each time. For number two, you note that blue triangle is kind of moving to the left each time. So shaded triangle moves one counterclockwise each time. Now, that's a pretty good answer. There are other ways of describing that, but we can't always say left because at a certain point, then it starts to move right to go back around and complete that circuit. So, the word counterclockwise is a good way to describe that. For number three, you could say that they're adding four each time. It's kind of tempting to think that they're multiplying by two when they go from four to eight, but then that pattern doesn't hold as we go through the list. You kind of have to use some logic, find the pattern. And then for number four here, they're subtracting five each time. Again, notice that each time language, that's an important concept as we're describing patterns. So after we've learned to describe patterns, our next objective is to be able to continue a pattern. So here there's a couple different patterns going on. You can see we've got like an arrow shape within, it looks like a diamond or a square that's just sitting on one of its vertices, one of its corners. And we start with a green arrow up, then we go a red arrow left, then a green arrow down. And what we can see is this shape, the arrow within, is kind of turning and changing color each time. So it's like turning counterclockwise and also changing which direction that, or which color that arrow is. So our next one, we're going to still have this diamond shape. All of our figures have that. And then now the arrow, if it's going to keep rotating, it's going to go to the right. And it's going to change color again. So the part of the figure that's not the arrow is going to stay blue, but now the arrow itself is going to be red again because it has its own pattern. It's alternating between red and green. So the next figure should look like that. All right, now we've got a pattern made of stacking blocks. And we have a growing number of blocks each time, and they've numbered the figures 1 through 5. We need to sketch the sixth figure. Well, we notice that the first one over here, it just has one unit across the bottom. The next one has two, and then three. That's what those numbers are identifying. So if I'm going to keep that pattern going, the sixth figure, the one that we're supposed to draw in, it should have six boxes along the bottom. And then it just kind of makes that nice little stair step going up the side, and eventually it ends up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks high in this one, so this one should have 6 blocks high. And then we'll fill in that stair step. And that should be the next figure in the pattern. All right, and for the examples that you are going to try on your own, I would suggest pausing the video here, and you need to continue the pattern 2 times. So you've got two figures that you have to draw in. Go ahead and pause the video now and give that a shot. Okay, and we're back. Now, I don't have a whole lot of room, and you probably don't either on your note packet, but I'm just going to put some solutions down here. For this first one, this is similar. We've got changing colors and a rotating figure. So now our figure seems to be rotating clockwise, meaning that the first one that we have to draw points upward, and the next one is going to point to the right. Right. And as far as the shading is concerned, that blue one is going to be here and here. And then the first one that we have drawn in should be green for the other half. And then second one should be red to account for the alternating colors. So that should have been our answer for number five. For number six, here we've got a growing pile of blocks again. We go 1 to 3 to 5 on the bottom. So for number six, our next one should have 7. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then we get this kind of growing pyramid shape in the middle. So that should be our first drawing. In number six, and then the second one should have 9 along the bottom row. Another, you know, odd number, the next biggest odd number. 7, 8, 9, and then again that growing pyramid design. All right, for number 7 and 8, these I can actually fit up here. What's our pattern in number 7? Well, it looks like we are subtracting 3 each time. I go from -2 to a number that is more negative. That means I had to take away more. I had to take away 3 more. And yeah, that pattern continues. I keep subtracting 3. So the next number in line should be when I take away 3 from -11. -14. And then when I take away 3 from that, -17. And for number 8, here our pattern looks like when I go from 4 to 10, I add 6. 10 to 16, I add another 6. And I add another 6 there. So I just need to keep that pattern going. What happens to 22 when I add 6 to it? I get 28. And then when I add 6 to that, I get 34. So those should be the answers we came up with for those examples.